Hey guys, Brian Henn with Henn Racing Technologies here. Today I'm going to show you how to install our two-seat doors on a Can-Am Maverick X3. The tools, the tricks, the tips, everything you need to make your life easier installing our cold doors. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to drill out the door check strap, and you're going to need a 3/16 drill bit, and you might need like a panel popper or a flathead blade because the rivet will spin around and burn the strap. So, see, this one's already spinning. Underneath here. Zip it out. Then your check strap's out. The door can open up farther. Now what you're gonna do, take a 13 millimeter, you can use a ratchet or an impact. Pull these upper hinge pin bolts out. The door stays there on the lower hinge pin, and then swing this in and the door comes out. And then you can pull out this plastic washer here, and you only need to use that down the road. Next thing you're gonna do after you have the door off, you're gonna install the door shock bracket. And you're gonna need just a few tools for this. You're gonna need an 1/8 inch Allen wrench, you're gonna need a 3/8 a wrench, and a 3/16 drill bit. Now when you do this, you're gonna put in your old mounting hole where you drilled out the check strap, you're just gonna line that hole up and put it there. Now it's key to get this surface right here parallel with these rivets. So don't have your tab out like this, swinging out. You just keep it in line following the rivets. So then you're gonna tighten down the one bolt, the one screw here. Get it snug. And then you're just gonna drill this hole right here. Make sure it's lined up. Obviously, make sure the drill bit's tight in the chuck. Okay, now put this screw on. I have to debar it a little bit, or you can just slightly screw it in. That's fine too. Get it going. And good. Make sure they're both snug again. Just double checking. And then your bracket's on. Next, we're going to show you how to install the doors. The next step of what you're going to do is you're going to get your door latch out. Okay. Basically, you're going to use a T30 Torx bit, pull this plastic cover out, and get your red pull strap out of there. Now on this instance, this has a lever and whatnot, but this is on a 2017. So what we're gonna do is we're actually replacing the latch. We have a new latch from BRP. We have them on the website, or you can get them from the dealership. They're like 20, maybe 30 bucks or something like that. So on a prior video, we have our door lever install kit. Okay, so that way you can kind of see how to drill this out, pull the strap out. It's a 3/16 drill bit to drill this, and then you step it up to 1/4 inch on this bottom hole, okay? Then we can move forward and mount them on the doors, and we'll show you that here right next. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna install the new latch. We've already drilled out this to quarter inch. It was a 3/16 hole. We ended up pulling out the old hardware, the old screws out of the other latches here. So you're gonna install them on the inside. Now you don't have to do this process right away. You can actually leave them loose. You can do it towards the end after you get the door swinging. I'm just doing it right now just to show you on the table. And kind of start in the happy medium. Start in the middle of the slots. It's slotted right there. Start in the middle, just for a general rule of thumb ballpark. You don't even need to tighten this one down all the way. And then we'll bolt the lever on. Now the lever, you can use either hole. We typically do this on the inside or the outside. The inside is for door bags if you want a little bit shorter. 9 times out of 10, we're using the outer holes. Now, also on the lever install video, it'll show you how we do it. So we put one bolt one way, and we put the other bolt the other way. This way you can tighten down the nuts and get a wrench on there. If not, the flats of the wrench will prevent you from tightening it down. Go ahead and tighten these down and we'll get it buttoned up here. Okay, so now that we have these tightened up, it was just a 3/16 Allen and a 7/16 wrench to tighten it down. This lever is going to come with the lanyard pre-crimped from us, and then you're going to get your upper pull pin. This is how you get in and out of the door instead of reaching around, also with our windows. Okay, so you're just going to put this pin in and you're going to loop it through this hole and come through. Okay, so now when you have that, the kit also comes with this little U-bolt. Okay, and when you do that, you're going to unscrew these nuts and just tighten it down. Now you have a couple options. You have, this can either be a 5.5 millimeter socket, or it can be a I believe it's a 7/32 socket. 7/32 socket, or a 5.5 when you pull for these small nuts. Now the other thing about these small nuts are, when you get it tightened down, you're going to you're gonna have a lot of extra thread. We normally nip these off and cut them off, so that way they don't get hung up on the window flange and the window provisions, window net provisions and whatnot. We'll get that tightened down and we'll move on to the next step. Okay, as you can see, we have it bolted down. See how long the bolts are? That the U-bolt still hanging out. And also, you can see as you tighten it down, it can fray out. So what we're gonna do is, we're just gonna snip this off so nobody gets hurt and you don't cut yourself. Just normal cable cutters. You can use side cutters too if you have a sharp set. And we're just gonna use a cutoff wheel and lop that off so they're flush. If there's little burrs on them, you can sand them down real quick. Now this is stainless steel, the cable and this, so you don't have to worry about it rusting or anything. Also, this is a 16th inch cable, so if you are in your garage or you have some more tools, you can always use another, you can use a cable crimp and actual crimp it on there like we do the swag with a swag tool. Next thing we're going to show you is the doors here, the Heims. What I want to do is clarify this here for you guys. So you're going to want to keep the bronze, is the bronze oil light bushing. And if you look, we have a T stamp there. And right here, we have a B stamped right there, top and bottom. Okay, this is key because the top is 5/16 for our new upper hinge pin, and the bottom is 8 millimeter. So these chassis on the pins are 8 millimeter. Now, they'll come all the way threaded in. Now you're gonna want to keep this receiver, or this, the top of the bushing, see how it's pressed through? You're gonna wanna keep that up like this, so that way the upper hinge pin encapsulates it and it doesn't fall out the bottom. Same with this, because your lower pin will be, keep this bushing in. So they will be a little bit tight when they go in. It'll be snug, okay? They'll break in after you open and close the doors a few times. Now the bushings can come out. It's fine, don't worry about it, because they'll be encapsulated, okay? Okay, so next thing you're gonna do is a general rule of thumb. What we're gonna do is we're gonna turn these out when they're all the way threaded in. So this one's, call this one all the way almost threaded in, okay? You're gonna turn it out, let's say 8 full turns. We'll start 7 to 8 full turns, okay? So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, all right, so there's 8. All right, and do the same with the top. Okay, hopefully it counted right. Then you just bring the jam nuts in, it's no big deal for right now. All right, so you're just gonna put, you bring that all the way in, slide on, and then what you're gonna do is you're gonna swing that over, and then if you do have the latch on ahead of time, you just latch it on and it'll stay put. Now what you're gonna do, you're gonna go over to you're gonna grab your 13 millimeter and we will get the upper hinge pin bolted on. Okay, so just install the bolts, you can put the washers back on. Now if you do our windows, you don't want the washers on there, and I'll explain that in our full door with window install. Just put them on, you just lightly zip them down. Okay, now what you're gonna wanna do, this is key about, there's only a few points of adjustment, okay? So what you're gonna do is on the two door, okay? You can loosen it up if you're trying to figure it out how to get, because there's a lot of slot movement. You're gonna wanna push all the way in on the two door, so you're all the way jammed up, all the way against that slot. Now if you're a four door, you're gonna want it all the way pulled out, okay? So when you're on the outside like this. So we're pretty good there. What that is actually gonna do is that is gonna get you flush with the rocker by pushing this top door frame in when you tighten down those bolts. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we have our 8 full turns on the back of the heims of the rod ends. Now, typically, we want a 1/4 inch gap right there, okay? That way it sits nice. So we're a little bit farther away. We're probably 1/2 inch or so. Every gas door is kind of as flimsy here. And also you can see we're a little bit tight here. So what we're gonna do is we have a paint stick, so you can just break a paint stick in half and use that as kind of your gauge. So you can use anything, 1/4 inch shim as far as it goes. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to the Heinz, we're gonna loosen that back up, and we're gonna give it a couple more full turns just to suck it, keep the door here. The next thing is you wanna keep the gas door or even on the plastic flush, relatively flush when you're doing this. Now if you have to in order to get this flush, what you're gonna do is you can adjust this heim out farther, and that's gonna tip the door up, or those plastic washers you can put that come from the factory, even the top one, you can double stack them and put them there in order to give yourself a little bit of a shim. We all know how bad these Can-Am chassis are. They can fluctuate. There is no rhyme or reason for the 8 full turns. We've had doors in here that are, they're sucked all the way in the Heims, or they're all the way out. Just giving you a general rule of thumb, start with maybe 7 or 8 turns, kind of see what's going on. And then you're gonna want, also, the gas door kind of throws you off a little bit, but you're gonna want this, like I said, the adjustment of the latch, you're gonna want this relatively flush. Now mind you, you still have the door skin to keep it flush, and we'll show you that here shortly. Okay, so now that we have it finally adjusted, pretty close anyhow, you can see here how far we had to adjust it out. Be careful not to adjust it out too far. Make sure you still have thread engagement. Usually about 1/2 inch is what we like, because it's 1/2 inch thread. At least have 1/2 inch engagement, ballpark. Now, we're gonna tighten these jam nuts down afterwards. It's almost like the very last thing. So as you can see right here, we adjusted it out for the 1/4 inch gap. Also, in order to, we adjusted the latch, if you look, it's all the way out. Every chassis can vary. So take this for a grain of salt on this one. We've had them sucked all the way in. It just depends. But it opens up smooth and glides pretty decent. What you can do, I'm gonna show you on, this is the striker, okay, to the latch. And so what I'm gonna show you is down the road and later on in the video, how that can be messed up and it may not match right in line and it might hit. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna take a dead blow hammer and lift and smack the bottom or smack the top. I'll get into that. I'll actually show you how easy it is to manipulate. Next up is a door shock. Pretty easy. All you're gonna do is click it on and then we'll, click it on, good to go. Now it stays open, shuts, and you're good. Okay, so a couple of things about the doors. These right inside of here on the welded Zeus tabs, you have your Zeus springs, okay? Now, these Zeus springs that we use, they're 1/4 inch, 0.250, and then we use 1/8 inch steel rivet. By chance, if you order up raw doors, we'll give you the rivets, because we assume that you're gonna powder coat them, or you have a powder coater and you're not buying them powder coated from us. So we will give you we'll give you steel rivets, but we won't have them clicked in, so that way you don't have to drill them out, because it's a pain in the butt to get the rivets out and drilled out fully. Now, next thing is you have a couple of options. You have raw aluminum Zeus, or you have a black anodized Zeus. Now, these Zeuses are 0.400 long. Now, if you're going to get into boat decking on the interior, and we'll go over that a little bit later, you're gonna want longer Zeuses. You're gonna probably want a 500 inch long Zeus or a 550, which we'll put that option on the website if you plan on going with some decking. Now, we have a couple of things. So we have this, they're not on the website yet, but we'll put them on. This is the keychain, this is one of our keychains. We have a Zeus driver built in. So you can always have this on your key, fits perfectly in there, and you can turn and unturn. These are quick turn, just you'll see in a second here. Or if you have, you gotta be careful with you can use a normal screwdriver. This is an actual Zeus driver that's radiused, okay? But if you use a normal screwdriver, be careful when you're turning in, they don't slip off and gouge your powder coat. Okay, so you're gonna take the door skin, and what we always do is we line it up here. Sometimes it helps with 2 people, okay? But we start with the top center, okay? So you're just gonna turn it until it starts locking into the spring, just like that. You can kind of let it go, but we're gonna hold it up and you're going to click it on, okay? So now it can still pivot, all right? What you want to do is you want to keep the door skin pretty close to center line of the top of the door bar. So then you can just kind of align it. May have to shift it a little bit because there is a little bit of wiggle room. So we open these holes up to 1/2 inch and it's only a 7/16 Zeus, so there is a little bit of play to manipulate it. So you're gonna line it up halfway on center line, click that second one in. You're pretty much good to go. Now it may bow out a little bit, that'll get taken care of when you button it up. But as long as you get this top row relatively centered and you still manipulate it a little bit, and usually we get that top row in, get it kind of locked in. You can always readjust it, okay? You see it's just a quarter turn, they're good to go. All right, now you can work your way around, all the way around. Now this front one, you may want to open up the door, and I always start the Zeus with my finger first, make sure it's into the spring, and then turn it. Like I said, you can definitely gouge your powder coat when you're trying to click these on. Just work your way around. You gotta move, put your leg into it to start it and to get it going, you're good to go. Now, this will be the final test, see how it is. It's really hard with these Can-Ams and the plastics. We try to get them flush, okay? And this, as you can see, it's not totally flush here. So what we'll go back and what we'll do is we'll loosen up this upper hinge pin if there's enough play, and we'll try to, we may even get inside the car, one person pushing out on the bottom while another person's here with the impact, and tighten it down, and then it'll stay. The other thing is once you have this on, you can make sure that all your gaps are, you know, the best they can be. If you gotta shift the door skin down, make sure it's sealed up. Now, every RCs are probably the worst that I've noticed as far as having something, you know, it'll stick out a little bit. So a little bit of manipulation, just because the chassis are bad, you gotta be careful, but you can physically bow this in. Just take your hands or even a block of wood and you can see clamp it and bend it. You have to be careful that when you bend this, that you're not going to, you very well could, this rivet and the Zeus, you could dimple it right there. So you just want to be careful when you're doing it. You can even pull the door skin off, give it a little bit of tweak. You won't crack the powder coat, you'll be okay. It's just because the chassis are so all over the map. This one went shut, it's not too bad. It seals right there, okay? Next, what you're gonna do is you're gonna grab a 3/4 inch wrench and you're gonna tighten down your jam nuts, lock them down. After you get everything final adjusted, and this will keep it, make it even more rock solid, and you're good to go. Okay, so just real quick on the doors. Our door handles are in factory location. So a lot of questions are, what door bags fit? Any door bag will fit. The cool thing about our doors is that they're wider. So if you have a knee pad here, you don't necessarily need it, okay? The other thing is with our doors, we're the only manufacturer that allows hard windows with full doors, okay? So what we do is we add this window flange on here. We weld it on and it'll come with these riv nuts built in. Now the thing about it is when we do this, it's actually a bigger process than most think. It's not just welding this flange on, because when you weld onto this flange, it actually contorts the door. We have to straighten the frames and everything afterwards. Even after they're fully welded, when we weld this on, it makes the doors all cattywampus. The other thing is our door frames are completely TIG welded. So you don't have to worry, it's just, we're definitely a quality over quantity shop. The other thing is on the door shock rod, okay? You have a couple of holes of adjustment. They come, we always have them already tightened down, always double check, but in the third hole, that'll give you the most. We never go in the back door, or the back hole, because the back of the door can physically can, depending on how far out adjusted it is, it can hit your plastics. So you can play with it, mess around with it, but that's a general rule of thumb that should speed up the whole process for you guys to install these doors. If you have any questions, definitely reach out to us. You can email us on the website or you can call the shop, 810-215-1066. What we are going to show you is a few different other options that we are offering that we haven't put on the website. Our new door tip doublers and some limit straps, actually. I can show you real quick. So what we ended up doing is on this back bolt hole, we actually have a cable, okay? And what it's going to do is it's going to go behind this bolt hole here, this bolt right here, and it's going to bolt right there. So what's going to happen is it's actually going to bring your door forward just a smidge. So that way, if you don't shut your door all the way and it doesn't double click or latch, what's going to happen is it's going to check on this cable before it breaks this and spring your door. So this is a really cool feature, and the door tip doublers, we'll show you that here shortly. Okay guys, so I just want to show you on this build that we did, the latch, or the safety lanyard. So see how tight it is right now? You still have a little bit of wiggle room right there, but it's cinching here. Just goes underneath there and on that back adjustment hole, okay? Now if you look in here, this is exactly what I was talking about. The other one's threaded all the way out on the bronze one that we did, and this one isn't nearly as bad. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you, and this is our window provisions. This can also be for door bags, window nets, so on and so forth. So right here, this is our new door tip that we're doing. They come in all powder coated colors. We have a bunch in stock right now. We're getting ready to put them on the website. But as you can see, that's how you get in with doors, okay? We'll go through on how to fit the doors. This is for our cage and so on and so forth. But again, that's how everything works. This door skin itself, a lot of questions on this. This is for the BR. So this has Mudbuster fender flares and it has BRP fender flares. So on the physical order form on the website, you're gonna want, there's gonna be two options. One is for like that door, or with a notch out that has it cut differently for BRP fender flares. That is the difference in between the door skins. We will put these on as an option as well. And this actually is light tint. This light tint scratch resistant. And we're gonna show you real quick the striker, how to manipulate the striker if you are off. Now real quick, if you do go with, and we're gonna do it on this build, this is a C-deck liner, it's foam. It's also kind of like a sound deadener. So this is what I was talking about, if you need longer Zeuses, if you're using this. That way you don't have to cut around the Zeuses. You can just get, we can provide you with longer Zeus fasteners. We are going to put this as an option on there. There's all sorts of different patterns, colors. We have a blue honeycomb, and just, they make all different colors. You can see it all over the internet. We'll be putting that on as an option as well. Already installed on the door with longer fasteners, or if you need fasteners, we can get you taken care of. Okay, so with the striker, and you have your latch attached to your door, a lot of times it can be a little bit lower. So what's going to happen is when it rolls, when the latch rolls up to the striker, it will still latch, but it'll lift your door or drive your door down. So what we do is very simple. Just smack it up with a dead blow. Before you have the door skin on, just look and see, make sure that the striker is in the center of this, okay? Just like that, okay? So again, just smack it with a hammer. We'll use a dead blow, a soft hammer. Believe it or not, these move very, very easy
up or down. You just have to whack it once and it'll be good to go. You can use a 2x4 and a mini sledge if you don't have a dead blow. But that way you just adjust it. When they weld these to the factory, it's just one big loop and it can be contorted down or up. It's just the Can-Am chassis on how it is.
Okay, so one last little thing about our doors that sets us apart different from others. Our door skins are made from 80 thou thick 5052 aluminum. Pretty much aircraft grade that you still bend. It is stronger than your typical 3003 aluminum that a lot of the other door companies use, and it's thicker. Also, when they're latched, vibration, we don't have vibration. You can physically move the whole car with the frame without having, I mean, they're rock solid. So definitely, we strive for quality here, and we want you guys to have the best out there.